Society. We are so glad that you can join us tonight for our first in-person concert since January of 2020 in the wonderful acoustics of St. Mark's Lutheran Church. Also, a special welcome to all of our online audience, through the camera there that we're broadcasting. We hope as COVID protocols relax further, we can have a full in-person audience. You can all join us live and in person. I'd like to thank our board members, musicians, and donors for making our concert possible. Special thanks to the St. Mark's Foundation for a generous grant supporting tonight's presentation. As usual, all of our concerts continue to be free and open to all, but are only possible to support by support from our donors. If you would like to support us and keep the music going, please go to our website, sanmarcochambermusic.org, and see how you can help. Thank you. Now, as this is a live audience and live streamed, Please remember to place your phones on silent. Thank you. Before we begin our program, we would like to dedicate the performance to the memory of four people who passed away earlier this year. Ruth Conley, Pamela Heumann, Hugh Patterson, and Lonnie Rowell. They each played an important role in the musical life of Jacksonville and the San Marco Chamber Music Society. Ruth Conley gave generously to the symphony and virtually every classical musical organization in Jacksonville. Pamela Heumann was a regular concert-goer here and joined us on our tour of Germany. Hugh Patterson sang on one of our diabetes benefit concerts and sang with the symphony chorus. And Lonnie Rowell attended many concerts here and knew many of us through his stagehand work and his bass playing. They were all wonderful and supportive individuals and will be greatly missed. Now onto our musical program, Underrepresented Composers. Our first selection is by Quinn Mason, an African-American composer based in Dallas, Texas, whose music I first encountered last summer when I discovered his piece, In Memory, a solo viola work that he arranged for oboe, which I performed on the Jacksonville Symphony's virtual concerts last summer. Quinn has been described as a brilliant composer, just barely in his 20s, who seems to make waves wherever he goes. We will open tonight with the first of three duets for viola and cello. It is rhythmic, it's like a conversation between the viola and cello. Please welcome violist Ellen Olson and cellist Brian Magnus.
He's also a viola player, and he plays viola in the organ symphony. too familiar with. It's In Lonely Mountain Ways, which I found out is actually a Japanese hymn. And the third one is I Come With Joy. And DJ Cheek is joining me for this duet. He's the principal viola of the Jackson Symphony, and I'm very glad to work with him. So I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
begin with the first of three wind quintets that we'll be performing today. I will be joined by Lucas Lestrupkis, clarinetist Giovanni Bertoni, bassoonist Conrad Cornelison, and French horn player Kevin Reed, all of whom I am proud to call my colleagues in the Jacksonville Symphony. Jeff Scott, composer of Homage to Duke, was born in Queens, New York. He is a horn player. He performs with a Grammy-nominated group, the Amani Winds, a quintet which is dedicated to the performance of underrepresented composers and performers. He was a graduate of the Manhattan School of Music, taught horn at Montclair State University in New Jersey, and last summer was appointed horn faculty at the famed Oberlin Conservatory. His quintet, Homage to Duke, is in memory of Duke Ellington and his sacred music. During the last 10 years of his life, Duke Ellington wrote several choral works as he thought about his mortality and spirituality. We all know about him for his jazz. This has a lot of jazzy qualities to it, but I did not realize until we selected this that he has had another side. He presented sacred concerts, which included choir, his band, and dancers. This quintet reflects this lesser known but important part of his career.
Thank you.
Quintet by Carlos Oliver Simon. He's a native of Atlanta, one of the recipients of the 2021 Sphinx Medal of Excellence, which recognizes extraordinary classical Black and Latinx musicians. He's composed for many major symphony orchestras, such as New York Phil, Los Angeles Philharmonic, and Philadelphia Orchestra. As a keyboardist, he has performed with the Boston Pops. His music is influenced by jazz, gospel, and neo-romanticism. This quartet, especially, I would say, is definitely neo-romantic. This piece is called Elegy, Cry from the Grave, and is dedicated to the memory of Michael Brown, Trayvon Martin, Eric Garner, and Alton Sterling. We'll just take a minute to tune in, and then we'll start. Hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Our next quintet that we're sharing with you is by a friend, Onovwerosuoke, who was born in Ghana to Nigerian parents. He now resides in St. Louis. He spent time in over 30 African countries learning about various African musical traditions. His composition, Rhapsodies for Woodwind Quintet No. 3, subtitled Healing Dances, alludes to homeopathic rituals still practiced among the forest peoples around Central Africa, which Fred Onovwerosuoke points out has parallel traditions with Native Americans, Eskimos, and others. This is a joyful piece which perhaps will lift us up during this challenging time, the challenging times you've been experiencing, and enjoy.
Making sure it works.
Thank you.
by George Walker. I like to call George Walker the Jackie Robinson of the musical world, the classical music world, because he broke the color barrier in so many ways. He was born in 1922. He went to Oberlin, Curtis, and Eastman in the 1930s and 40s, which was, you know, unheard of for a black man those days. He was the first black composer to receive the Pulitzer Prize in Music in 1996 for his work Lilacs for voice and orchestra, which the Boston Symphony performed with Seiji Ozawa. This piece is well known as Lyric for Strings, but I found out recently that he did not like to call this quartet version Lyric for Strings. Just there's a large orchestra version that's Lyric, and he preferred to call this his second movement of his first string quartet, which he also, he called it Slow Dance, but it's often compared to Barbara Adagio for strings because it's so beautiful. So I hope you enjoy it, Slow Dance by George Walker.
Thank you. Okay, so our final piece. First of all, thank you all for coming out. And we really do enjoy having an audience more than you know. And it's been very consistently at first last year playing for no one and then playing for distant audiences. But we're well on our way back. This piece is, I think, a fantastic piece, a great way to end this program. I won't go into a long explanation. If you want to, when you go home tonight, Google or just do a search on Reena Esmail, and the light is the same. And she has a wonderful thing online, about 2.5 minute explanation of what this music is and what it's about. And I couldn't really do it much justice. She's of Indian descent, India. And this music is derived from forms of her heritage and her native music. It's, as she describes, two different ragas, which have to do with rhythm and the scales. For us, it's maybe the thing, the piece tonight that takes us the furthest from our comfort zone of Western idiom. Even Fred O's piece was very comfortable in a dance rhythm that we can accommodate. This one is challenging. It really breaks into two sections. A section that is the first two-thirds of the piece about that has this sort of very gently undulating pulse and rhythm, and everything over it is completely loose and free and pulls and tugs at the rhythm and doesn't ever really quite line up with it. Like a jazz singer would sing in and around and behind and before the beat. It's a challenge. The last part of the piece is the challenge for us. So this is the kind of music that, for people that play this music from their birth, it's in their stream. Every bar is changing from mixed meters and 12/16 and 15/16 and 9/10/16 and back into 4/4. And it's a complex, just the opposite of the beginning of the piece. It requires this precision of rhythm and something that's not quite in the zone of what we play a lot. So anyway, I think it's really fun. It's a great piece, I think, and I hope you enjoy it. It's a piece that we're playing for the first time now. I would like to play this piece 150 times. And then we would really probably know how to play it. But you're our guinea pigs here tonight, so we're going to try it on you. And I hope you enjoy it. Oh, yes. I might need that.
Les is going to retrieve his piccolo.
I would have turned that page and said, ooh. Deception to go. Next year.